Please remain standing for the presentation of the delegate.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for the presentation of the delegate.
Please be seated. Welcome to 2013 Minnebago High School Veterans Day ceremony. I'm pleased to have a lot of our veterans here for the 8th Creek County. Always a pleasure to see that people standing in the back and I'm walking them up front. Good to see those people too. I'd like to introduce now our high school, Mr. Carl Lowe.
Good morning. I want to welcome all of you, especially our parents and guests and our veterans, to our 2013 Veterans Program. It's truly an honor for me as a principal of this great school to be able to help in a small way recognize all of our veterans for their contributions, not only to America, not only to our state, but to our community. Without your dedication, we wouldn't be able to enjoy the many benefits, unfortunately, some of us take for granted. At this moment, before we move on, I'd like to recognize the special guests that we have here at Minnebago High School today. We have Dr. Beth Everett, a county school superintendent. Before I recognize the veterans that are on our staff, I would like to do something different and ask all of our veterans, both here at Minnebago High School and our guests that are veterans, to put a stand so we can recognize you. Please say veterans. Excellent. At this time, we want to recognize the veterans that are on our staff here at Minnebago High School. Dr. Patricia Edwards Beal, please say 1993 to 2001, U.S. Army First Sergeant. Lieutenant Colonel Alan Byrne, 1984. Board President, there is ongoing mobilization to Operation Liberal Freedom, deployed 2010 Operation Iraqi Freedom. Ms. Olivia Curry.
Thank you. Day, we feel the solemn pride and heroism of those who died in the country service and with gratitude for the victory, both because of the thing from which it has freed us and because of the opportunity it has given us, America, to show our sympathy with peace and justice in the councils of the nation. After World War II, there were many new veterans who had little or no association with World War I. The word armistice means simply a truce. Therefore, as the years passed, the significance of the holiday changed. Leaders of veterans groups decided to try to correct this and made November 11th the time to honor all who had fought in various American wars, not just World War I. The name was changed to Veterans Day by Act of Congress on May 24th, 1954. In October of that year, President Eisenhower called on all citizens to observe the day by remembering the sacrifices of all those who fought so gallantly and through rededication to the task of promoting an enduring peace. The President refers to the change of the name to Veterans Day in honor of the service of all America's wars.
You were the first one, yes, it's all.
today's guest speaker. For Sergeant Donnie Henry joined the U.S. Army in October 1978 with the late entry program. He joined while he was still a senior at the Bell McGinn. For Sergeant Henry graduated high school and went to the United States Army Military Police School. Upon completion of basic training, spent the next 10 years on active duty, two tours in Germany. 1993, First Sergeant Henry then became a member of the South Carolina Army National Guard, as well as a member of the Ada County Sheriff's Department. During this time, he held many positions. First Sergeant Henry has two deployments with the Global War on Terrorism, one in Iraq, and his most recent deployment to Afghanistan with the 1221 Engineering Rifle Clearance Company. Before I let Sergeant Henry come up, I got a list of his reports here. And as you all know, talk is cheap. Okay? Everybody can talk. You hear it every day in the hallways, people talk, not doing much. Performance is what counts. And every day, what you achieve and what you perform is how you're going to be measured. On a military uniform, every ribbon, every badge, every emblem has significance. It's a mark of achievement. You've been somewhere and you've done things. And I want you to notice that when First Sergeant Henry steps to the podium. His many awards during his career. He has the Air Assault Badge, the Combat Infantry Badge, Army Commendation, Army Achievement Medal, and a whole slew of medals as he's been somewhere and done something. It's topped off by our nation's third highest award for bravery. First Sergeant Henry is a recipient of our country's Bronze Star for Valor. These achievements represent a lifetime of his commitment to protect and serve. Protect and serve our country, to protect and serve our county, and now the privilege of having is our best call to protect and serve in Valley High School. Ladies and gentlemen, First Sergeant Donnie Henry.
Good morning. I'd like to thank Billy Bell High School for asking me to speak today, for Dr. Shelby, and thank you to our veterans. Many of you, I see there are familiar faces who I've served with, and I'm proud to say that I've served with. Yeah, like I said here, I've prepared some notes, but while listening to some of the music, you don't know who you are, really touches. I may not know the sailor, I may not know the airman, the Coast Guard, the Marine. However, there's a bond that we share together, that we look in each other's eyes and we know we're brothers. A quote from President Reagan, there are some who have forgotten why we have a military. It's not for no war, but it's to be prepared for peace. That's what our veterans have provided, that peace and freedom. They are constantly serving and protecting that peace. They have sacrificed greatly, not only as a veteran being deployed, their family members, some being the mother, the father, all thrown up into one, while either their mother or father is deployed. It puts a great hardship on families and it affects everyone. Yep, we have had veterans. And as I walk through the front yard, there's three crosses out there that mean tremendous to me. Corporal Matt Dillon was my driver in Iraq during my first deployment. On return, Matt chose to join the Marine Corps, redeployed, was killed in Afghanistan, Iraq. Staff Sergeant Willie Harbaugh, Sergeant Luther Rader, their two crosses, also joined the front yard. Both of those soldiers came to my top of campus. They were backing up to save another soldier's vehicle that was struck by an IED. Both sergeants died while trying to save other soldiers. They, again, have left their families. The hardest thing with that is having to fly from one place to another until a soldier that his father was killed in a roadside bomb. We have several that have paid that price, and they're still paying today. As I walked through the VA hospital, and I see other veterans, as they're there for care. There are wounds that you may not see. You may not feel, but they feel. I promise you, I'll like to keep this short. My task to you is when you see a veteran, don't feel sorry. Shake their hand and say thank you for your service. Because they did it to keep you free, to let you, or so you were able to come to this school. Your education, study what you believed in. By making the right decisions, I sat here and I watched as a program I've never seen this auditorium so intense with these students. Keep that intensity as you go throughout your life, making the decisions that you do, making the right decisions for your education. That.
Thank you.
Brigade Commander Commodore Daniel Butterfield played with sax among the many he had lost. Unable to compose the Hunger Valley, which is 80 low down in musical notation. The Hunger Valley played it that night to honor their dead comrades. It was officially recognized by the United States Army in 1874. Taps is the highest honor given to those who have died in service to our country. Would everyone please stand for a moment of silence and remain standing for the flag of Taps? Yes, and please do not clap now.
United States.